Hi all, welcome to PowerShell for Penetration Testers at Pentester Academy. In this video, let's have a look at exploring and using cmdlets. So let's get started. In the previous video, we had a look at the help system of PowerShell with the get help command, and also there was a mention of get command cmdlet. Let's have a look at the help of get command cmdlet. As you can see in the help description, that the get command cmdlet gets all commands that are installed on the computer, including cmdlets, aliases, functions, etc. Let's use get command once to see what it returns. So it returned aliases, function, cmdlet, etc. Now, to list only the cmdlets, we have to use a parameter called command type of get command and ask it to list only the cmdlets. As you can see, now get command is listing only the cmdlets installed on this machine. How do we know that get command supports a parameter called command type? By using its help. If we list the full help of get command, there is a section called parameters, under which we can see all the parameters accepted by the cmdlet. On a quick side note, how do we know only the parameters accepted by a cmdlet? If you have explored the get help cmdlet, you will know that it supports a parameter called parameter, which allows us to list the parameters of a cmdlet. As you can see, the previous command lists all the parameters accepted by the get command cmdlet. Another quick thing is, I am using the pipeline operator frequently. The pipeline operator, like in other shells, could be used to pipe output of a command to another. Also, since PowerShell is an object-based shell, everything is treated as an object, so it is quite easy to pass objects between various commands. Now, let's explore cmdlets of a particular type or name using the get command cmdlet. Let's list all the cmdlets which contains process in their name. So we have 5 cmdlets which have process in their name. Let's use get command to explore a couple of more cmdlets. Let's try using service. So there are many cmdlets which have service in their name. Now let's use this command again, where we listed all the cmdlets installed on this machine, and let's count or measure the number of cmdlets installed. For that we can use measure object cmdlet. You can explore it by using the get help cmdlet. So as you can see, there are 236 cmdlets installed on this machine. We can use various cmdlets after exploring them. For example, we saw the get process command, which lists the running processes. We can use get service, which lists the running services. But if you want to do a specific task, how would you zero in on a cmdlet? As we saw earlier, cmdlets in PowerShell follow a verb noun naming convention. So to get a command which stops something, we should use the verb parameter of the get command cmdlet. Let's use stop here. So there are 5 cmdlets which contains the stop verb. Let's try a very simple thing. Let's explore the cmdlets and see if we can start something. Let's use start process to start a simple process on the local machine. Let's quickly see the examples usage of start process. As you can see, it is very easy to start a process with get process. Let's start notepad with start process. Now let's try to stop this or all of the notepads using the stop process. Before that, let's see the help for stop process to see the ways of stopping a process. We can use name, we can use PID, etc. Let's see examples again quickly. So we can stop a process by name, by ID, etc. One interesting thing is seen here. We can also pass an object returned by get process to stop process for stopping that process. For example, in our current scenario, let's list notepad. So right now there are 4 notepads running on my machine. Let's try stopping this let's use stop process ID 13468. Now let's run get process again and see the number of the notepad processes running. As you can see, one process has been stopped. Now there are various interesting commands or cmdlets. For example, we can list the hotfixes installed on a machine using get hotfix. We can create files, remove files, create registry keys, etc. In fact, if you went through the get help or the help system of PowerShell, there are some conceptual topics this is the return of the get hotfix cmdlet. So there are some conceptual topics which talk about cmdlets. Let's quickly have a look at it. Get help wildcard cmdlets. So if you list the help for command, you will see something called about core commands. And if we see help of or about core commands topic, it lists some core cmdlets which could be used to work with various things in PowerShell. It talks something about providers, which we will have a look at later on. That is all about cmdlets. As an exercise, you can explore cmdlets using get command and pick 10 cmdlets which could be useful in penetration tests. That is all for this video. If you are enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please do recommend us to your friends and colleagues in information security community.